Here's the Peanut individual. This is how the inverter is wired up. You'll see you get a single lead coming out of the inverter. It's going to connect into a 2-to-1 connector. So that 2-to-1 splits it between the two panels. You got one end going to the far panel, and then you get one end going to the closer panel. There's two light strips on the panel, so it has a 2-to-1 connector also. So you're looking at 3 2-to-1 connectors. You got one from each switch panel, and then you have one that creates like a Y going to each of the switch panels. So you got 3 2-to-1s, since there's only one lead coming out of that inverter. All that gets bundled up and wrapped up nicely. This is the individual Peanut EIM replacement system. It's the same situation for the individual rectangle for the small sun decks. All the larger boats are somewhat similar in the way the inverters are attached to the harness. If you are going to replace an inverter, I would recommend just removing the panel, undo your two plug connectors, and do it just like I'm doing here on a bench. That's the easiest way to replace that inverter, is not in the boat, but just take that panel out and do it somewhere where it's a little more convenient. All right, here's the inverter all installed. You notice these tiny little wires. Make sure you leave plenty of loop there, because when this harness flexes back and forth, you want to make sure those don't get pulled. Those tiny little wires, we zip tie and tape them so they're a nice neat bundle, but they end up on the nav light switch. And we protect them by putting these little wires kind of on the inside of the switch. We use these brass male, male, female connectors. They're called piggyback connectors. So you see this tiny little wire with the little red quick connect. So if you're ever going to mess with these, if you're ever going to replace the inverter, make sure you buy two more of these red connectors and buy two more of these brass piggybacks. These brass piggybacks, once you put a quick connector on there, it's kind of tough to get them off. You usually need some pliers to kind of take this all apart. So make sure you buy enough parts to make it easy on yourself. Now these piggybacks go onto the terminals nice and easy. So that was the negative one hooked up to the negative daisy chain, and you'll see the positive one is down there. Same situation. I had already pulled this one off, so I'm gonna make that a little tighter, and that'll go right on like this. Okay, but that's how we do that. As explained before, all the 2-to-1 connectors for the inverter. This is all nicely, neatly wrapped up. And this is the other side of the 2-to-1. And this is going to connect to the other panel on the other side of the boat. Another thing you can do if you're in a hurry or in a jam is really just order a new inverter with a couple new 2-to-1 connectors, and just disconnect the light strips here on those quick connects, and you would just zip tie a new inverter right on the harness and just make new connections, and you don't have to worry about cutting zip ties or rerouting tape or any of that. Just install a new one and leave the old one in place. That can be done if you're in a jam. Need to get it done quickly.